Good morning, everyone. Nice to meet you through this Tabanaka lecture. Today, I'm here once again through the lecture Tabanaka. I'm so much glad and happy to see you. Most welcome. As I shared last time, the Ark of Incense, once again, I want to share together this issue, the Ark of Incense. First, let's see the scripture. Yes, in the book of Exodus, chapter 30, verse 4 and 6. Two gold links you shall make for it under the molding on both its sides. You shall place them on it two sides, and they will be holders for the poles with which to bear it. 5. You shall make the poles of acacia wood and overlay them with gold. 6. And you shall put it before the veil, that is, before the ark of testimony, before the mercy seat, that is over the testimony, where I will meet with you. Yes, we led up to here. As here, scripture say, when you make the ark of incense, you put this one before enter to most holy place, the before the veil, before the ark of the testimony. So it is like this. I will show you the picture. Yes, this is the place, the holy place. And then you see here the veil. Now you see the veil. So we cannot see inside. But when the high priest enter, high priest like remove this veil and enter into a most holy place. So scripture say, you put this the ark of incense just before the veil and before the mercy seat. Let's see the scripture once again. This verse say, you shall put it before the veil, that is before the ark of the testimony, before the mercy seat, that is over the testimony, where I will meet with you. So God spoke, this place, the most holy place, is the place I will meet with you. Like this mercy seat, I will show you through the image. Like this. This place is the place, a holy place. And here is the most holy place. And this place is called mercy seat. And God mentioned, I will meet you here. But here, you see, before the high priest enter to this most holy place, where God says, I will meet you. So, he passed through this, the ark of incense. So God say, you put this one, before the veil, and before the mercy seat, before the ark. So just before he enter into this most holy place, the high priest must pass through this the ark of the incense. So why God say this one? This ark of the incense, through this one, there is something God really want. We know exactly. First, as the scripture mentioned, this place is a place where God wants to see us and meet us. But there is one problem. Which problem is that? Yes, this place is a place God mentioned, I will meet you. But this one, this place is called most holy place. So not anyone can enter. Only high priest can enter. And even high priest cannot enter every day. He can enter once a year. So only one time a year. So it means God say, I want to meet you here, but not every day, not anyone can see God, only one time a year. And when the high priest enter, he must follow order, what God say to Israel. So when we see the scripture, even, you know, the high priest Aaron, his son, they enter here, but he didn't follow order God. So, you know, they pass away. So you see scripture, I will show you. Explain through the Leviticus chapter 16, verse 1 and 2. Now the Lord spoke to Moses after the death of two sons of Aaron. Yes. They enter, you know, when they enter, they brought a different fire. We see when they offer a profane fire before the Lord. And the Lord said to Moses, Tell Aaron, your brother, not to come at just any time into the holy place inside the veil before the mercy seat, which is on the ark, lest he die. For I will appear in the cloud above the mercy seat. So through this one, you see, when high priest enter into the most holy place, not just any time, not just any time can enter, because once a year they can enter. And then when they enter, there is many order like this. Verse 3, those Aaron shall come into the holy place with the blood of a young bulls as a sin offering. So when the high priest enter, he must enter with the blood. Blood of a young bull and of the lamb as a burnt offering. So when he enter into the most holy place, even he should bring the blood. And then verse 4, you see, he shall put the holy linen tunic and the linen trousers on his body. He shall be girded with a linen hash. And with the linen turban, he shall be adorned. There are holy command. Therefore, he shall wash his body in the water and put them on. So when he enter, he needed to prepare completely according to what God says. So what I'm saying, you know, when someone enter into the most holy place, you know, they cannot just enter according to, you know, they want. There was many order. Even once a year, it's not easy to enter. You know, they should prepare many other things, like tuning garment and wash their body, and so they should carry the blood. So when they enter, there was so many order. They need to do this, they need to do that, and not everyone, not any time they enter. So even though God say, in the mercy seat, I will meet you. But even though God says so, it was not easy to see God because there was many order. But before enter into this most holy place, as we share this ark of the incense. This ark of incense, just before the entrance of most holy place, God say put this one. Why God say this? This one. Just put the in front of this veil. It's because through this smoke. This smoke can enter into this most holy place, though the people couldn't enter freely any time they couldn't enter. But this smoke, each every morning and evening, any time this smoke could enter into this most holy place. Now this smoke, arc of incense smoke, representative of our prayer. So through our prayer, we can go heaven, even we can communicate with God anytime. So this is the function of the arc of incense. So even though we cannot see God every day, face to face, but through this prayer, we can see God, we can meet God anytime. So even in the story of Ark, it was a time the poor and the chilla enter into the prison. But before I explain of that story, I will let you know this one. In the book of Revelation, chapter 8, verse 4, and the smoke of the incense with the prayers of saints ascended before God from the angel's hand. So, as this smoke could go to the most holy place, our prayers of the saint ascended before the God. So, this smoke representative of the prayers. So, the smoke enter into the most holy place anytime. So it means our prayer can reach to God anytime we can communicate with God. That's why God say when you put the ark of incense, you put just before enter to the most holy place, just before entrance of most holy place. So that even though everyone cannot enter, and not every time they can enter, only one time a year, but through this smoke can enter anytime. So through this one, anytime God can see, us, and God can interact with us through our prayer. That's why the ark of incense is so much important. Even through the story of the book of Acts, there was a time Paul and Silas, they preached the gospel. But that time there was a persecution. Someone who had the woman who spoke the fortune teller. So the before they make up the demon possessed go away, the people beat them, the Paul and the Silas, and put them into the jail. So it was a quite trouble and difficult. But while they was in the this jail, what did they do? The scripture say like this: when they was in the jail, the Acts of chapter 16 verse 25 say, but at the midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. So what did they do while they was in the prison? They prayed. Yes, while they was doing praying, even though they was in the prison, through prayer, it's not matter where they are. They can, come close to God. They can communicate with God. So while they pray, it seems like all the problem, delivered to the God. Then once that problem, the problem came to God, now it is not their problem. It is like the God's problem. So while they pray, through prayer, they can see God anytime. And then when they pray, it seems like they deliver all the problem to God. So it is like this, you know, even though I don't know how to fix the vehicle, my car, but if I, you know, if I give my vehicle to a mechanic, the one who can fix, from that time, my car problem is not mine. From that on, you know, the person who fixed the vehicle, mechanical, that person is the one who needed to care and solve that problem. So likewise, you know, no matter which problem we have, while we pray God, we deliver all the problem to God. Then from that on, all the problem which I have is not mine. It belongs to God. So God cares those problems. God considers all the problems behalf of me. So that's why, you know, while the Paul and the Silla, when they was in the prison, actually, you know, they couldn't praising God, even they couldn't sing the hymn song. Why? Through the situation. You know, they were beaten a lot, even they was in the prison. But while they pray, it seems like, you know, they are closer to God, and, you know, they sat next to God. So even I could remember, you know, the testimony of Pastor Park, our founder. He prayed when he had a lot of trouble and difficult. Especially, there was no food. Even he didn't have a blanket to sleep. But that time, he prayed God. And then while he prayed, yes, he started to pray God to ask some food and a blanket, those things. But while he prayed, he felt, yes, he was in the cold place and without food. But while he prayed, it seems like he was next to God as a son, as a true children. So while he prayed, it seems like he sat next to God and communicate with God. So while he prayed God, he, you know, forgot his situation. Yes, he didn't have food, even he didn't have a blanket. But while he prayed, it seems like he was in the heaven place next to with God. So he didn't feel any problem, you know, while he prayed. Then he could pray on the side of God. God really wants to preach the gospel all over the place. So he prayed like this, like, you know, please, you know, allow this gospel spread all over the world. So please send the missionary to many other countries. And please allow this gospel spread through the broadcast. Please allow the broadcast, and then please allow publish books, spiritual books. So, you know, while he prayed, it was like he lose and he forgot all real situation. Like he don't have food, even he didn't have a blanket. But while he prayed, it was like he was together with God. And all those problems, it belonged to God. God, you know, care all those problems. So same this way, while he was in this while they are in this area, like prison, you know, they pray. And while they pray, even they feel all the problem is belong to God. So like this, we can see how God really want we pray before God. And while we pray, actually all the problem we speak to God, and those problem is not my problem. All the problem will deliver to God's problem. So this is a function of prayer. So through pray, we can say everything as we are children of God. So even though we cannot see God face to face, only high priest once a year, you know, this high priest could meet God, as God mentioned. But through this act of incense, from the ark of incense smoke come out, then this smoke can enter into most holy place. Anytime, any day. So this smoke can reach to God, and this smoke can meet God. So what is the smoke? Smoke is the prayer. So we can pray God anytime and any day and with any issue, any problem. So if we pray, God as children of Him. So He listens and He also cure all our problems. So this is why we pray. So even before I start this tabernacle lecture, I pray God. And also while I pray God, I fear all the problem, God will solve it. And all my issue, God know, and He will care and He will lead my life. So this is why we need to do pray anytime, every time, even morning, evening, then God can hear our prayer. So today, once again, I could hear the function of the ark of incense. So God say, put this in front of the entrance of holy, most holy place. Most holy place, not everyone can enter, not every time enter. That's why through this smoke, enter into the most holy place anytime. So most holy place is the place where God stay. So through this smoke, like smoke is a prayer. Through prayer, we can meet God and we can communicate with God anytime. So today I share up to here. We see next time once again. Thank you.